Good afternoon. Welcome to Strength Flow. Coach Chris here. If you're on a yoga mat, go and start off on the back of it. We are going to sneak right into our world's greatest stretch. So take your time pulling that chin down to your chest. I want you to roll down to the floor. Lengthen that posterior chain, hands to floor, walking those hands on out to that plank position. Once we get there, I want you to work that left foot outside of that left hand. Nice and long from the top of your head through that right heel. I shall lizard lunge here. Now let's see if you can lower down that left shoulder. Exhale. Let's take that left hand to sky. Strong rotation through the hips. So we're not just reaching, rotating through the hips. Right now let's go and take that left hand outside of that left foot. Peel that left hip back to a deep hamstring stretch. If this is the first thing you're doing in quite a while, be nice to the body. Let's not feel pain. Maybe you did a quick. If you're feeling warm already, it'd be a little bit tougher on the hamstring. You can handle it by now. And left hand inside of that left foot. Brace the midsection. Left foot goes back nice and slow. Now let's work that right foot outside of that right hand. Long from head to heel. Let's lower down that right shoulder. Right hand to sky and rotating through the hips. I'd love for you to feel a little bit of the outside of that right hip right now. It's kind of that glute med, QL area, a little bit of IT band. Right hand outside of right foot, pulling that right hip back. If you're feeling like this stretch is pretty easy, you can start to lift that chest a little bit. Increasing that intensity. Let's take that right hand back inside the right foot. Again, brace the midsection. Turn it on as you take that right foot back. Let's drop the knees. I want you to take those feet out in front of the body. We're going to work into our shin box position. For right now, let's go ahead and keep those hands to the floor. So hands are behind us, toes are pulled towards the knees. We're going to drop those knees to the left. And right knee leads the way, opening the groin, challenging the hips. Until the left knee needs to follow. Now left knee leads the way. Right knee follows. Right knee leads the way. Left knee follows. These are going to be pivotal later on. We got some new moves today. Left knee leads the way. Right knee follows. And back to our starting position. Go ahead and lie onto your back, please. Make sure there's nothing behind you to hit your head on. I want you to bring that left leg or left knee over top the left hip, and I want you to press your left palm into it. Now give yourself a little bit of tension, all right? Make your left palm and your left knee fight each other, right? They're pressing into each other. Now I want you to take that right hand, reach overhead, and lift that right leg off the ground. Now bring your right elbow to your right knee. And reach out. And back in. Reach. Back in. Reach, back in. Are you still pressing that left hand into that left knee? Reach, back in, relax. All right, guess what's next? Right hand into that right knee. Extend through that left hand and that left foot and bring it in. Reach, bring it in. Reach, in, reach, in, reach. And reach and relax. That's your midsection. All right, let's sit on up. And let's stand up on up. All right, so we got four movements we're going to work through in our circuit today. We're going to work for roughly about 40 seconds, 40, 45 seconds, about 15, 20 seconds recovery between each one. Some of these are some you're familiar with. We have two very new moves in today, or new flows. And then we have time at the end of class. We are going to practice some Turkish get-ups. All right, so we got three rounds of our main four movements. Our first one, pretty simple-ish, but I want you to really think about control through the body. So no hips moving around as we walk those hands out. So let's go embrace that midsection. All right, roll the body down to the ground. Walk the hands on out nice and controlled. Hips don't move side to side, 1 inch. Push up, push up. Walk those hands back. Roll up, vertebrae by vertebrae. Back down. Hips don't move side to side at all. You're strong as you walk those hands out. Push up. Back up. Your base. Feel that roll coming out of that standing and hinge position. Strong push-ups can be done on the knees as well. 10 seconds. And hips have not started to move. Let's finish up that rep and relax. All right. So there we were nice and curved through our spine. All right, this next move, we're going to take angles, straight angles. Head to tailbone, strongest heel. Tailbone to heel, strongest heel. All right, so let's get into our plank position. Down dog. That's where those straight angles come in. All right, we're going to break the rule a little bit. Bend the knees as you drop the hips to your heels. And now press back up. Back down. Back up. Bear squat. Your pace. Dropping the hips. Pressing those hips high. Dropping the hips. Press high. You're pressing through the balls of your feet. You're trying to stay as straight as long as you can from your hands to your tailbone. Seconds. Five, four, three, two, and relax. Drop the knees. All right, so once you step back up in that shin box position, I want you to make sure you have plenty of room side to side. All right, so feet are out in front. I'm going to start slow because we're going to do this one together. Knees to left. Come on to that left forearm, reset right hand overhead, shin box forward. A lot of us know this one well. Now that right hand slides back. As we come up, that right hand comes back to the ground, all right? And then we get to that center position, hips lift, reach that left hand across the body as you work our hip bridge, and then drop the hips. Knees go to the right, right forearm, reach that left hand overhead. Back to center, left hand comes to the ground, hip bridge. Reach that right hand across, feel that midsection pull on strong. Drop hips, left forearm, reach right hand overhead. Back to center, right hand comes down, extend through hips, reach left hand. Back down, knees drop to right, right forearm, left hand overhead. Slide it in, let's go one more beach. Left hand comes down, hips drive up, right hand reaches. Hips drop. Knees drop to left, left forearm, reach overhead. Back to center, right hand to ground. Extend through those hips, reach that left hand. Drop those hips, knees to right, right forearm, reach that hand overhead. Excellent, all right. So let's reset, go to yoga mat, get on two. We're gonna get to our supine position, go lying on back. We're gonna work some roll-ups, which can often be a pretty easy movement, but we're gonna add a little fun to it. All right, so just imagine you're a rope over top of you right now, hooked into your ceiling. I want you to grab onto it. Pull yourself up. Lower yourself down. Pull yourself up. And down. Grab onto that rope. That rope's doing all the work. If you're not helping, your pace, up and down. Twelve seconds. Finish up that rep. And relax. All right. That's our four moves. Let's get back up. Stay in position. You can add speed to that hand walk, to that push-up. But again, no hips side to side. We stay straight line. Head to heel, strongest heel. Take it down. Walk it on out. Push up, take it back, round up, the side profile. Again, we're adding some rounding to this one. It's a strong push up, and as soon as we can, you need that fold, rise that vertebrae by vertebrae, then chin to chest, all the way to floor, before getting back to that push up position. Save the hips. No hips side to side. Five, four, finish up that rep. Three, two, one, relax. All right. Bear squat coming back up. Again, strong triangle to start things off. And then we break the rules by bending those knees. All right. Let's get on into our plank position. Punch those hips up and back. Pull those hips to heels. Extend up. Let's work. Do you think about here, if you really want to get some good flexion, just think about taking the back of those knees to the wall behind you. So there's dots on the back of your knees, and that's what you're trying to get to that wall as we extend through and use those strong quads. 4, 3, 2, 1. Relax, drop knees. Bring those legs on out in front. All right, so if you've got that fold, shin box, the shin box fold to that hip reach down, you can go at your own pace, but I'm going to coach this one just like we did before, working a little bit slower. But again, if you've got that one down, you're more than welcome to take off. All right, shin box position. Knees to left forearm, walk that right hand overhead. Bring that right hand in. Right hand goes back behind you. Extend hips up, reach left hand across. Back down, knees drop to the right, right forearm, left hand overhead. Left hand back in, left hand to floor. Extend your hips, reach that strong right arm. Back down, knees go to left forearm overhead. Right hand back to floor, extend through hips. Left hand reaches. Drop those hips, knees to right forearm, overhead with that left. Back in, left hand to ground. Drive those hips. And back down, knees drop to left forearm, overhead. Got one more rep if you're with me. Back in, right hand to floor. Drive through those knees, extend through those hips. And down, right forearm, left hand overhead. Relax. All right, if you're on your yoga mat, go and find that center again. We're gonna get into our supine position, making it onto our backs. Pull that midsection in, grab onto that imaginary rope, and let's work. Lower it down. You heard a big thud? Don't worry, everything's fine. I've just got crazy kids. They love to play above the garage when dad's coaching. Use that rope to lower. Now we're in control of every inch of this movement. Five, four, three, two, and relax. One more round. All right, rules haven't changed. You can go quicker. Control through those hips. And when I'm talking about walking out, your hips are not doing this as you walk those hands out. You're a straight line. Feet under the hips, chin to chest, roll to the floor, walk it on out, strong push up, walk it back, stand tall, back to that round. Think fluidity outside of the push up. Feel the movement of the shoulder blades as you stand, as they squeeze back. Take them back forward before you round back to the floor. Got time for one more rep. If you're working through that rep right now, finish it up strong. No rush. Got plenty of time. Relax. Good work. All right. Bear squat coming back up. Big breath. All right, if you'd like to get in that plank position, spot with me. All right, punch those hips up and back. Pull those hips down. Drive those hips up. And let's work. That cue, when you think about those dots on the back of your knees, as you really try to drive through the back of those knees, getting that full extension through the legs. Five, four, three, two, and relax. All right. We get that shin box fold to that hip bridge coming up. Again, notice that last round, but if you feel comfortable with that movement, go and take off as soon as you're ready. But if you're with me, knees to left, left forearm, right hand overhead. Right hand slides in, right hand goes behind the right hip. Hips lift, reach that left hand across the body, feel that midsection engage. Drop the hips, knees to right, left hand reaches. Back in, left hand behind the left hip. Hip bridge, and down. Reach right hand over top, back in. Right hand behind right hip, extend through the bridge, pulling back down, knees go to right, left hand overhead, back in, left hand behind left hip, bridge, pull back down, knees to left, walk it over top, one more in each direction, back in, right hand back, bridge, left hand reach, pull it down, right forearm, left hand overhead. Back in, left hand behind left hip, extend bridge, pull it down, reach overhead, and relax. All right, gonna work that roll up, grab it onto that rope one last time. It's not imaginary, it's there. I'm sorry if you're telling me it was imaginary earlier. Take it on down, grab onto that rope, pull yourself up, and lower yourself down. You're strong, you're strong. I feel like my imaginary rope is getting harder. I feel those legs wanting to lift. My hip flexors really want to try to take over. It's amazing how your body knows how to cheat. Finish up that rep. And relax onto the ground. All right, so we got about 2 minutes left. At the beginning of class, I told you if we had time at the end, we're going to work some Turkish get-ups. We're pretty much going to work the first three movements or the breakdown of the Turkish get-up. If you have no idea what I'm talking about, that's fine. That's the point of this, because eventually I'd like to get us to where we can start incorporating this movement into class more often. So what I'd like for you to do now is lie on your back, extend your right leg, your left foot is flat on the ground, approximately in line with your right knee. I want you to take that right hand off to the side of the body, about 45 degrees. I know this camera angle, you can't see my right hand right now. All right, reach that left hand in the sky. Now, what I want you to do is reach for the ceiling as you come onto your right forearm. So your shoulder blades are off the ground. You're on your right forearm right now. Now, I want you to straighten out your right arm so your palm is on the floor. And now, I want you to extend through the hips. You're in a bridge position, nice and long through the body. Now, pull down the hips, right forearm, left shoulder to ground, nice and slow and controlled. Let's do that again. Right forearm, right hand, extend through the hips, pull hips down, right forearm, left shoulder to ground. Let's go one more. Right forearm, right hand, extend through those hips, and back down, nice and controlled. Excellent. Let's switch feet. Now you can see that left hand is 45 degrees off the floor. As I press my right hand to the sky, I'm going to come onto my left forearm. And now my left hand, too busy looking at the camera. And I'm going to extend through the hips. Nice and strong, top of the head, through the heel. Point hips down. Left forearm. Right shoulder comes down. Left forearm. Left hand. Extend through the hips, back down, left forearm, right shoulder, let's go one more, left forearm, left hand, extend through the hip. All right, now if you're curious, where do we go from here? Yeah? We're going to slide that left leg in underneath the body. We're going to press those that nice tall position here. That's now we're in a half kneel. We're going to turn that left foot so now we're in line at the bottom. And then we're going to stand tall. And that's how we're going to wrap up class. Y'all are awesome. Thank you for hanging out with me, Strength Flow. We will work in the Turkish get-up as a true movement in this class. We're offering. I'd like to see us work it. But thanks for joining me. Y'all have a wonderful evening, and I'll see you back here tomorrow, same place, same time.